I'm Kevin Hogan, Executive Director of Auction Services for Rock Island Auction Company, and I want to personally invite you to attend this exciting Premiere Firearms Auction September 13th, 14th, and 15th. In terms of historic, fresh, rare, and investment quality firearms, it truly does not get any better than this upcoming sale. Just like with any collectibles, whether it's stamps, cars, coins, or sports memorabilia, collectors have their own niche. And in the gun business, over the last 5 or 6 years, we have witnessed a tremendous influx in collectors and investment purchasers for 20th century military arms, both foreign and domestic. At Rock Island Auction Company, we pride ourselves in our ability to procure and sell some of the very best collections, and this September sale will have some interesting and intriguing opportunities for those World War I and World War II German collectors and buyers. Featured in this auction will be items from two very well-known collections. A large portion of the items in this sale come from the collections of Mr. Chuck and Sharron Lindley, and we are pleased to offer some choice pieces from the collection of celebrated Walther expert and author James Rankin. In addition to these two collections, Rock Island Auction's September premiere event is offering some fantastic individual and unnamed consignments. Let's take a minute now to get a closer look at this extraordinary World War II Walther factory relief engraved cased presentation model PPK pistol with documentation that was reportedly made for Reichsmarshal Hermann Göring. This beautiful pistol is accompanied with a notarized certificate of retention and custom declaration, along with a signed letter of explanation from Second Lieutenant Weisberg, who obtained this specific pistol directly from the then Walther plant manager, Conrad Muller, in May-June of 1945. At this time, Lieutenant Weisberg was assigned as a captured materials officer, assigned specifically to the Walther plant to inspect and seize any appropriate war material for the U.S. During his assignment at the factory, Lieutenant Weisberg was given a plant tour by Conrad Muller, and at the end of his tour, Muller gave this pistol to Lieutenant Weisberg, stating that it was illegal for him to have it, and he wanted the pistol to go from a German to a German descendant. He additionally stated that this pistol was manufactured and engraved specifically for Hermann Göring in early 1945. However, the war ended before the Walther factory could actually make the presentation to Field Marshal Göring. This specific pistol has been beautifully engraved in a non-traditional deep relief vine pattern, which is what we call non-traditional in the sense that most of the German guns you see have the heavy oak leaf pattern. It's a 98% engraved gun, which extends, you know, all the way from the end of the muzzle here on the underside of the barrel to the trigger guard, to the trigger itself, to the magazine plate. It really is truly a 98% gun. Certainly this pistol would have been engraved by a senior Walther master engraver whose skill would be emblematic of Field Marshal Göring's rank and status in the Nazi Party. Next, we'll move on from the Walther to this early, rare Mauser 1912-1914 prototype, serial number 162, semi-automatic pistol in 9mm Luger. This is a very fine example of an extremely rare early Mauser prototype. These were all produced around the same time the 1912 Mauser humpback pistols were manufactured. They were based on the smaller 1910 pattern Mauser pistols and scaled up to use a larger 9mm caliber. It is estimated that fewer than 200 were ever manufactured, with no more than a handful known to exist today. It's estimated that approximately 8 were sold between 1914 and 1916 in the U.S. The highest recorded serial number so far is 166. This one is 162, which certainly indicates a very late production pistol. The condition is very fine, and for a Mauser collector, it does not get much better than this. Moving on next, we have another experimental prototype pistol. We have this ultra-rare DWM model 1902 American Eagle U.S. Army cartridge counter test Luger. There were exactly 50 of these pistols produced, all in the serial number range of 22401 to 22450. And this serial number of this gun is 22409. The cartridge counter device was ordered by the U.S. Ordnance Board in late 1902 and was scheduled for testing in early 1903. In April of 1904, these cartridge counter Luger pistols were issued to the cavalry and light artillery boards at Fort Riley, Kansas for field testing. On July 4th, the cavalry board issued the final test report on the model 1902 Luger, which recommended that these Lugers not be adopted for service as the POW indicating device was too fragile and did not hold up well. All were returned to Springfield Armory and held for many years before being disposed of in the 1920s and 1930s through local sales. Again, if you are in the market for a cartridge counter, there is no telling when or if you will ever see another one again. Moving on from the cartridge counter, I'd like to discuss this small little Walther Model 9 with ivory grips attributed to Adolf Hitler. This fine pistol features full coverage scroll engraving in high relief with a lion's head on each side. The engraving very closely resembles the engraving found on the Adolf Hitler PP, shown on page 33 of Rankin's book, Walther Volume 2, Engraved Presentation Standard Models. This pistol, in Rankin's opinion, may have been engraved by the same person. The pistol is accompanied by a type, unsigned letter dated January 1st, 2000, briefly explaining that an official of the U.S. State Department, with the cooperation of the U.S. and British governments, helped himself to a myriad of German treasures after the formal surrender of German forces on May 8, 1945. The official was said to have access to Hitler's yacht, the medieval castle of Weldenstein, Göring's 200-acre estate and hunting lodge north of Berlin, and the homes of Himmler, Speer, Bormann, and others. All artifacts were shipped to the U.S. under diplomatic immunity. This pistol is reported to have been in storage in the U.S. since 1946. There's also a signed letter of provenance from noted Walther expert James Rankin describing the pistol and its attribution to Adolf Hitler, and its engraving having been possibly done by the same engraver that engraved the Adolf Hitler Walther PP pistol. The letter also states that this pistol, along with other firearms and pieces of war memorabilia, were purportedly removed from the eagle's nest. Then we have a particular rarity in this pair of DWM 1900 American Eagle Test Luger pistols. Now let me show you this exceptionally rare World War II Walther factory engraved gold-plated Nazi presentation PP pistol with ivory grips identified to Nazi Chief of Police Helmut Gommlich. Now for long arms. Our September premiere sale features this scarce late war production World War II Mauser Model G41 semi-automatic rifle. These rifles were produced in 1941 and 1942 in response to the request by the Germans Weapons Office for a semi-automatic rifle. These are very scarce today as they were produced in small numbers early on in the war when the Mauser factory was using the time-consuming all-machine parts and components, with most of these rifles seeing considerable use throughout the war, especially on the Eastern Front. Other sale highlights include this rare Class 3 fully functional World War II BNZ code Steyr manufactured German MP40 machine gun. We have Luger carbines, party leaders, MG34s, MG42s, and remember, this is only the beginning, so save the dates. Our preview day is September 12th. The auction is three exciting days, September 13th, 14th, and 15th. It will be a vast and diverse offering of some of the most significant and spectacular firearms we have ever offered. For more information, visit our website, www.rockislandauction.com. For instant updates, like us on Facebook, follow us on Twitter, and subscribe to our YouTube channel. This is an auction you can't afford to miss. Hope to see you then.